Hi, in today's video, what I want to do with you is share with you a project that I found in a magazine called Bushcraft and Survival Skills. Okay, this is March, April of 2011. And it was an article written by a friend of mine. Let's have a look. There we go. Okay, Jason Ingemels. Let's try and get a close up of his mug. There we go. And he runs a bushcraft school in the UK called Woodland Ways. And the project was to make your own leather cup. That's the project. So what he did, he went through over the three pages, was it four pages, just make sure. Over the three pages, all the details of how to make your own cup. And he actually put in the magazine, templates. Okay, they're the templates. So, what I did. Come on, the squirrel, let's move that away a minute. I photocopied the pages out of the magazine, okay, as you can see here, and then I was able to draw around them on some card. So I got myself some templates. Okay, so rather than ruin the magazine, I've got them as cardboard templates. And I can keep using these over and over again. Which means I'm able to go out and cut myself a series of discs. Okay, so these are the bottoms. And so I've got four bottoms there cut out. Okay, so I need to make a few of these. Okay, so I've got four bottoms cut out. These are the handles. Okay, there's one I'm just starting to form. I've got to stitch it together yet. And then this is the actual body of it. And when these are all formed and put together, you end up with a cup like so. Okay, a bit dark in here, I know. But you get a leather cup. As you can hear, it's hard, but it's literally is made out of, I'm using 3mm Vegetan leather, which is soft. And all we've done is put these in the oven, bake them so they go hot, paint them with beeswax, and you get yourself a hard cup. So what I want to do is, I've got a few to make, so I thought I'd bring you along and show you how we get round to making them. So I've used my cardboard template and I've cut out my piece of leather. Then I use a thing called a skiving tool, which I'll go and show you. It's like a potato peeler, and you can slice off to feather the edges of your leather. Okay, so I hope you can see it on the end here. So it feathers it off, okay? And this is so that when you fold the two pieces round and we stitch it, okay, we get a fairly flat edge. Thank you. Okay, so I've drilled all the holes for the handle, and I now need to form this handle into this shape, as you can see on this. So what we need to do is we need to obviously fold this round and stitch it. We need to wet it first to make it pliable. So I've just got a bowl of water here. Just going to sink it into the water. And we leave it in there basically until all the bubbles come out of it. Okay, you can see it bubbling. So once all those bubbles have come out, then we know it's fully sodden. So that's what I'm waiting on now. So now what we need to do is we start to pull this over. And now we need to stitch it. So it's got some nice thick thread. Should I go for the black? I think we'll go for the brown thread. One of my needles I want, and there's the other one. To take off a nice length of this, I always go for more than I need. Nothing more frustrating in you start and then you find it's too short and you haven't got enough to finish what you're doing. Just going to thread the needle. And what we're going to do, nothing new, it's quite common this stitch, but you put a needle on both ends. Like this. And then, and what I always do, I always start 3 stitches back. Okay, so we go in from 3 stitches back. And this is going to give me my lock to start with. Okay. And then we go up through the next one and out. Okay, we can start to pull it a bit tighter, and this one's going to come through this way, through the same holes. And give that a little tug. And back through again. Right, and we're now back to straight stitches. So now we can just give a tug on each one and it should lock itself. and then just work through the whole of the handle, and as it starts to form round, it will start to curl. You can see it's trying to curl this way. As we pull it up and start stitching, it should start to automatically curl this way round. And if it doesn't, as you're forming it and it's starting to dry, start forming it into the shape you want it to be, okay, like this. Okay, and it'll dry partly in that shape. As you can see, this one here, which is starting, it's starting to curl over. It needs to be re-wetted and done again to get the proper shape. Okay, so I'm going to finish this handle and I'll show you what it looks like finished.